In this video, I want to show you a very simple but super powerful trick if you ever need to implement the UI of a chat feature with an inverted scrolling. But before we start, I have a big thank you to the sponsor of this video, Stream. Stream is an SDK that offers all the features that you need if you want to add instant messaging to your app. So if you plan to add a chat feature, you probably want to check out what they offer before you start spending a lot of time implementing all of it by yourself. And by the way, Stream has also gained new features in addition to instant messaging. They can now also help you integrate real-time video calls or live streaming capabilities to your app really fast. So once again, I have a big thank you to Stream, and if you want to learn more about what they offer, you have a link in the description. And now, let's move into the code. When you want to implement a chat feature, the difficulty is that you need to have an inverted scrolling. Unlike most scroll views where the content starts at the top and then users have to scroll down to dig deeper into the content, for a chat feature, it works the other way around. The most recent message will be displayed at the bottom of the screen, and users will need to scroll up if they want to go back into the history of the conversation. So if you want to implement such a scroll view, your initial approach could be to iterate over the data in reverse order and then add some code to initially position the scroll view on the last message. This seems to work, but let's see what happens when the user scrolls up into the history of the conversation. At some point, we are going to need to load more messages. So I'm going to add some code to simulate that. And now let's see what happens when we actually start scrolling up. You can see that as soon as the new data has been added to the array, the scroll immediately jumps to another place in the conversation. Let me show you again so that you can see it happen more clearly. Of course, this is not what we want, and so now we need to write even more code to prevent that from happening. But I'm sure that you're starting to see that this situation where we constantly need to add additional code to counterbalance unwanted side effects isn't ideal and will definitely not scale well. So let's get rid of all this extra code, and let me show you the trick to implement an inverted scroll view super easily. First, I'm going to introduce a custom view modifier called flipped upside down. As you can see, this modifier is super simple. It just flips the content of the view vertically. Now I'm going to apply this modifier to my scroll view. And because the scroll view is now upside down, you can see that we are actually getting the inverted scrolling for free. There is just one issue. All of the chat messages are also upside down. So let's fix this. As it turns out, it's surprisingly easy to fix. We just need to also flip upside down each individual chat message that's contained inside the scroll view. And that's it. Thanks to this little trick, we have now flipped the scroll view vertically while its content still retains its original orientation. If we try to interact with the scroll view, we can see that the scroll indeed starts at the bottom, like we expect, and then when we scroll up, we can also see that older messages are nicely loaded and inserted into the scroll view without any issues. And that's all for this video. So remember, if you ever need to implement a scroll view with an inverted scroll, the trick to do it is very simple. Flip the scroll view vertically and then flip again each of its child views, and that's it. I hope that you've enjoyed this video. Once again, I have a big thank you to Stream for sponsoring it. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss my next videos. Thank you for watching and see you next time.